This tutorial shows the calculation of the effect size following significant post-hoc tests after a repeated measures one-way ANOVA in R. It is common practice to calculate the effect size D after observing differences in pairwise t-test. First, make sure the R statics package is loaded. Then, I'll start with the data frame and add the pipe operator. The next line is the Cohen's underscore D function that has the dependent variable followed by tilde, the small wave symbol, and the time variable. Don't forget the paired equals true argument. The effect size can be found in the column F size. Please note that effect sizes will always be reported as positive values. The negative sign is caused by the order of the measurements. Finally, you have to classify the magnitude of the effects for which you consider the p-value being small enough. I already mentioned that dichotomizing the decision against the null hypothesis by strictly looking at the p-value should be avoided. The magnitudes provided here are from Cohen 92, a power primer, page 157. If the effect size exceeds 0.2, it is a small effect, if it exceeds 0.5, it is a medium effect, and if it exceeds 0.8, it can be classified as a large effect. In my example, I have two significant effects that are classified as medium or moderate effects. However, please check if similar studies in your research field exist and compare your effect size with the given ones. If no comparable studies exist, use the common thresholds within your research field. If those are also non-existent, you can always refer back to Cohen 92, a power primer. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.